everyone, Cassidy here from Similarweb. In this video, we'll analyze the volume of digital traffic to your competitors and evaluate engagement insights to measure the quality of that traffic using the traffic and engagement page. We'll also analyze traffic and engagement over time to evaluate trends and spot any growth opportunities or potential weaknesses.
Let's say we're analysts at CNN and we want to research how our top competitor, the New York Times, has performed over the last 3 months in the US market. We'll start in the competitive research module and navigate to the traffic and engagement page. I'll enter CNN.com into the search bar. Here you'll see the top line traffic metrics for CNN.com worldwide over the last 3 months. I'm going to filter by the US to focus on activity in that region. Now, let's add our competitor, the New York Times, so we can view our digital performance side by side. The widgets at the top of the page show us aggregate metrics for CNN and New York Times. While both sites have more than a billion total visits, New York Times has a solid lead, ahead by about 100 million. Device distribution between the two sites is comparable, with around a 35 to 65% desktop mobile web split. And now we get to the engagement leaderboard, where we can compare traffic and engagement metrics side by side between the analyzed sites and understand which site is winning each one. You'll find a wide array of metrics in this table, all averaged over the analyzed time period. For a detailed explanation of each of these metrics, check out the Similarweb glossary. The top half of this leaderboard shows us traffic metrics that measure the quantity of traffic to a site. We see that New York Times is leading the way in terms of volume of traffic. But if we focus on the bottom half of the leaderboard, we see a more even split amongst engagement metrics, where New York Times has more pages per visit on average, but CNN has a lower bounce rate and a higher visit duration. Now that we have an idea of the average quantity and quality of traffic to these sites over the last 3 months, let's get more granular by analyzing traffic and engagement over time to see how these metrics are trending. This powerful graph helps us understand how each of these engagement metrics fluctuate from month to month. You can also view this data in even more granular detail on a weekly or even a daily basis. Spot spikes and dips so you'll never miss a trend. And don't forget to toggle the month-to-date filter to see the most up-to-date trends. Let's focus in on pages per visit, a valuable metric to look at for publisher and media sites because the more pages viewed, the more content engaged with. As we noted earlier, New York Times is consistently leading here. By analyzing pages per visit over time, we can see if pages per visit average is influenced by any standout traffic events. Let's filter this graph to daily granularity to pinpoint the exact days when we're seeing spikes and dips in pages per visit. We see that New York Times is leading the way throughout almost the entire analyzed time period. However, if we focus in on November 9th, we see that CNN overtakes New York Times for the first time throughout this entire analyzed time period. This is a signal to CNN that they should go back and look at the content that they posted on November 9th, as it brought some really engaged traffic to their site and helped push their pages per visit level above New York Times for the first time in this 3 month period.
In just a few short minutes, we found that New York Times is leading the way in terms of quantity of traffic, and we zeroed in on some spikes in engagement to New York Times and CNN that CNN may want to investigate further. There's so much more you can do with this data, so why don't you give it a try?